right, so a little bit about me and a little bit about what I do and why I'm here. My name is Karl Marx. She didn't call me a communist. She called me Karl Marx. That's all right. Just 10 o'clock this morning, I put on makeup around 6:30 this morning. My makeup artist got up and he said, "Karl, it's early." I said, "Yes, I know, but I got some things to do. I have not things to do for myself, but I have things to do for everyone that is out there that is fighting for a cause." So this morning, I got up, put on makeup, went down to City Hall, and they're doing, it's called March on Harrisburg, which they are 7-day march to Harrisburg to fight for human rights, civil rights, and the rights of corrupt government. So, yes. So they asked me, they said, "Karl, we want you to do us a favor. We want you to come out and do the national anthem, Whitney Houston." Can I borrow this stool? Is this okay?
Yes, yes.
All right, because I'm tired. I'm 48 years old, so I am completely exhausted. So, yeah, so I went and... Oh, she's a rock. Right here? So, they said, you know, "Karl, can you come out and do the national anthem?" And this is a streamlined community. These are people not only from Philadelphia, they came from Florida, they came from Maryland, they came from far and wide just to be there to fight for not my right, not your right, but for everyone's rights against corrupt government. There is not one man, except for this man above, that should be in control about what we do, what we say, and what we feel. If you want to be gay, be gay. If you want to be heterosexual, be heterosexual. But you do not have the right to tell me what I want to be and what I want to do unless you put a roof over my head, food in my mouth, and clothes my back. Thank you, Mama. So that was the reason why I came out, because I wanted to fight and let everyone know that you have a right to speak your mind and to understand that we are all here for each other. So I was blessed to go to that. And then I am, all right, so here we go. I am Southern New Jersey's queen mother for Southern New Jersey. I am the reigning queen for Chester County Pride. I am the only female impersonator that does Whitney Houston that has been certified by the families, you know, by the family of Whitney Houston to portray her. And let's see, 25 years I've been with Legends in Las Vegas, La Cage aux Folles in Atlantic City,
yes.
And I have traveled the world. But my mission is only to be seen, to understand, yes. And let everyone know that I'm here for you and not for me. So I'm blessed to be here, and I want to let you know that I have been bullied. I'm 6'4". If I take off all these pads, I think I weigh about a buck, 35 maybe. But I have been bullied all my life. I try to make everyone understand that I don't care what people have to say. I don't care if you want to look at me while I walk down the street. Now people are going, "Oh, gosh, she's gorgeous." But back then I had pimples, I had, you know, acne up the gazoo. No one really liked me, no one really cared for me, and I was, I tried to commit suicide a couple of times. I ran away from home and lived on the streets for about 6 months. I prostituted for a little bit. And very recently, well not recently, but 2009, I was diagnosed with HIV. I was on my deathbed, and this very flamboyant man came into my room and he says, "We're gonna save you because you have a purpose." So he came in there with my doctor, Dr. Cohen, and they said, you need to call your family. You need to get your last rites in because you are not going to make it. So, I got at the, they lifted me out of bed, I got at the edge of the bed, I got on my knees, I did a little prayer. I said, you know what? If you want to take me, take me. But give me the opportunity to do everything I possibly can for people to understand that just be loved and love each other. If you can let me do that, Lord, then I'm ready to go. So 2009 is what now? 2017, I am still here. T-cell count went from 285, which is almost close to death. The average is 635 for the normal human being. My T-cell count is now 545. And my viral load is undetectable, so I am healthy, I am strong, and I am willing. And I praise the Lord that He has been able to see you guys today. So with that said, if they don't mind, I'm going to do something for you. Is that okay?
I'm not afraid to
members and to the directors. Marcia, thank you for having me here. Jazz, you know I love you. Let's Be Real Radio, of course, DA Cox, Foxy. I really love you guys. Thank you so much for having me, and be blessed. And remember one thing, do not let anyone tell you who you can't be. Just be yourself.